Ex-inmates of Reddit. What was the stupidest thing you've seen a new inmate do on his first day in prison? Reach across someone's food. Is this a matter of courtesy or do people have to assume you're gonna frick with their food if you reach over it? Courtesy and respect. It's way more serious than someone who has never been locked up would expect. Went out to eat with some friends. Reached across my friend's plate to grab the salt. My friend has done time. He was like, "Heads up, you would never last in prison." Whoops, well now I know. Goofy looking kid. Curly hair. Thick glasses. He comes in. And for some reason he befriends me. He starts telling me what he did. Sexual assault if a minor. I told him not to be telling nobody that shit. Because it'll get you in trouble. The rest of that day and the next. I bailed out by then. I could hear him from across the hall telling other people. Not surprised if he's been kicked around a few times. Kid gets booked in, hits the unit and starts borrowing food and other commissary items. Before he knew it he was $200 in the hole. Problem is, in jail and prison, most people who are willing to loan items out expect two or three of the same item back. You know, interest. Very easy way to get yourself indebted is by borrowing any food or other items. Never get in debt while incarcerated. A slight twist. We had a pink wet floor sign that we would put up in the entrance to the showers, so everyone knew there was someone in there jerking off. The fun game was to watch the new guys, myself included, innocently walk into the entrance to the showers that very first time, past the pink wet floor sign, and then see him come skittering back out a few moments later. Was there ever a time where the guy didn't walk out? It was a minimum security prison. We were all relatively harmless. I don't think there was ever more than strong irritation from the guy jerking in the shower. After all, it had likely been done to him when he was new. I thought he meant in like a gay way. Tell literally everyone how he was going to escape, and showed off all the tools he was using. Was he stopped by the other inmates or by guards? Theirs was a mole. A snitch. Within hours of him trying to saw his way through the bars with the threads of the waistband of his underwear, we were searched and he was removed. In all fairness, he was awaiting trial and looking at 50 plus years. 50's a ton. What did he do? Collect call his grandma and just cuss her out and talk her like dog shit, because she didn't want to put her house up for collateral to bail him out. Anybody do anything to teach him manners? Or just mind their business? Nothing serious. He was shut out from having access to any of the goodies inmates were able to get. Baldwin County Jail in Alabama is quick to add charges and extend your stay to keep that hate count up. The jail was all about barely meeting requirements and keeping as much money as possible coming in. They were so cheap that they put beans with almost every lunch and dinner, and on Saturday and Sunday they didn't serve the usual three meals. You got brunch and an early dinner and then a single peanut butter and jelly sandwich around 7 p.m. Not shower. 4 weeks. He got his clothes ripped up and he was thrown half naked into the showers. They also tuned him up pretty good. Did anyone know why he refused to shower? Like, was he just gross or was he afraid soap would be dropped? Obviously not related to this guy, but I bunked next to a woman who refused to shower because she was pregnant. She was trying to become as unhealthy as possible in hopes that it would spur a miscarriage. She would also jump off the top bunks onto her stomach. She didn't eat for the first few days and she literally slept all day every day. I felt bad for her, but she was putting my own health in danger. I cut off 10 inches of my hair before going in to avoid getting lice, and I sure as hell wasn't going to let myself sleep next to someone who was going to attract bugs. If you have any sign of bugs, you go into isolation. I put in a request to move and made it very clear why. I told them that she was severely depressed and possibly suicidal. They let me move across the room to an open bunk, but nothing happened with her. She should have been in the medical bay, but they were too full. Probably fear of getting raped in the shower, or to make himself unattractive to rappy inmates. Excuse me, sir, there seems to be a mistake. I'm supposed to be getting out of prison today. You're in the wrong line, dumbass. Using his superior intellect, he came up with the best escape plan he could possibly think of. Good times. Crucifixion? No, they said I'd done nothing wrong. And I can just go home. Right, off you go then. When the skinny little street thug white kid walked across the yard and threw a Mayana at a bench full of full-blown Crips. Didn't see him much after that shitstorm. Not in jail, but when I was living in LA I was at a park and no joke some white kid did this as a joke to a group of black guys and they beat the shit out of him. I was 10-ish and nope the frick out of there back to my house lol. LOL some kid tried that at my school, got suplexed. God, the suburban thug white boys were far and away the most annoying cats in prison. Always begging for PC, always needing moved, always getting themselves into trouble. Not an ex-inmate, but an ex-company. Dude came in on drug charges. First thing he does upon walking into the pod is announce loudly enough that I could hear that he got drugs past the dipshits in intake. Yeah, not the brightest bulb, that one. LOL. Was he telling the truth, or just bluffing? The truth. They were in his ass. They didn't catch it on the bend and cough. At least you get the bend and cough. We're not allowed to make them do that. Hell, if you and see it physically hanging out their ass, you still can't remove it. You have to instruct them to remove it. Remove what, chief? Oh, my mistake, guess it was nothing. Worked as a corrections officer. Guy got busted for sexual assault of a minor. Figured everyone else in the tank was on similar charges, so began talking openly about it, feeling he was safe. We had to subdue 5 guys who jumped him in the rec yard. Guy was sent to the hospital as he was fairly unresponsive. He was sent to protective custody after that. Dude in my state recently murdered 2 child molesters behind bars. Said they were unrepentant and he's in for life anyway, so why not remove some evil from the world permanently? Those child molesters would have one day been set free. And this was a dude in for murder during a drug deal. Arguably killed a nice guy. Has face tattoos and is scary looking. But everyone hates child molesters. Is this the guy who told guards repeatedly that if he was left around these guys he would kill them? I believe he requested that he be moved, but it didn't happen. I think the story went that one of them was stealing the TV remote and changing the shows to children's programming. Kind of rubbing it in the face of every other inmate as he got his pleasure from watching these kids. And then the big lifer had enough and killed them. It was one pedo he killed while the guy was watching kids on TV. Then he was on his way to turn himself in. And he walked by another known pedo. And in his words, I believe this was a direct quote. In for a penny, in for a pound. So he pulled a U-turn and killed that guy too. Skinny kid, hippie type got busted with some weed. Someone else on the range was getting beat up for something or other and the kid tried to intervene. Just said hey, leave him alone. Got beat to within an inch of his life in the shower. Pro tip. In jail, mind your own business. Pro tip. In jail, mind your own business. I was still an intake in NSP. Nevada State Prison. A lil dude came in touting up shit, Aryan Brotherhood. So an app sent him on a mission to beat someone up. An old man. The old man beat his ass. I got to the yard, a black dude came into our unit, barking at a white dude about money owed. I was the only black dude in the unit. Black dude looks at me and says, Osiris, we go accept this shit. I raised up off my rack and said, I have to live here, dog, and laid my ass back down. Pro tip. In jail, mind your own business. I like how he said we. Like you somehow had a part in it. Like, no, dog, this isn't my problem. It's your money, your problem. Your problem, you deal with it. Sounds like a good dude. Kid came in and, I assume he has watched a lot of movies cause he figured he'd fight the biggest guy on the range. LOL. He wasn't even the toughest guy in the hospital he woke up in. Yeah, see, the problem people seem to forget when they talk about the hit the biggest guy there on your first day so people know you're not a little bitch strategy is that now you've pissed off the biggest guy there and now he has a vested interest in getting you back so that he doesn't look like a bitch. Told a kid there was a pool out at yard. Guard saw him waiting to go out in shorts with his shower towel and asked him what he was doing. Kid said, I'm gonna go swimming outside, it looks nice. Don't think I've laughed so hard in my life. It's unoriginal, but always funny. This one is strangely wholesome. It's just funny light hazing. Yeah, until you think about the mental age of someone who's so gullible they actually think there's possibly a pool outside at a prison that they can use just whenever, like this kid. You can also hit them with, "Did you get your madda daddy?" And when they ask you what is, you tell them they'll find out. So they get nervous and go around asking people, "What's the madda daddy?" Obligatory not me, but I know a guy, and his cellmate was a young 19-year-old kid. The kid was confused and in the course of talking about their leaves admitted he was bi. The guy I know told him, "Hey man, that's cool, but don't tell that to anyone else in here, seriously. I saw this show with a gay prisoner in it. He wanted to be in solitary. Somebody tried to rape him, so he grabbed their balls and squeezed hard. Then, with balls still in hand, he twisted them and flipped himself over. That sounds like effective anti-rape behavior. Monkey grabbing peaches defense. This idiot walked right into a Mexican gang meeting and almost got beaten up. Source. I'm the idiot. How did you get out of that one? When I first went in, this old white guy introduced himself and told this other white guy to look out for me. The other white dude came running from across the room. It was a big room, maybe 50 beds wide, grabbed my arm and pulled me out. He pushed me against the wall and said, "Dude, what the frick are you thinking? You would have gotten your ass beat and sent to the hospital." I asked him, "Why?" "That's the rec room, isn't it?" He said, "The Mexicans are holding a beating right now." Dude ended up saving me 3 times during my incarceration of 2 days. Subscribe and click the notification bell to get the best of British.